these are perovskite, actually a quadruple perovskite material involving calcium and
manganese. It's amazing the things they've done. In fact, many of them, to me, when I hear them get up and speak about their research and the activities, they sound like second or third year graduate students. I mean, they're very, very sophisticated. One of the major goals of the program was we wanted to prepare people to be leaders in developing technologies and science for alternative energy. So it's really we're very, very happy to see how the program has progressed. And it's great to have our first class finally graduating.
So most of the research I've done has focused on nanoparticle systems, specifically lead selenide and lead sulfide, using different ligands and types of film depositions to create solar cells. And I've spent the past 3 years in working in Christopher Murray's lab doing that, and now my senior design project is actually aimed at using these systems in a new novelty spray deposition method.
I remember each of these students when we met them as high school students and talked to them through admissions, but they've taken off as researchers and they really produced state-of-the-art research results that will actually impact alternative energy projects. And so it's really been a dream come true seeing them complete their 4 years here at Penn in such an amazing fashion.
I will be heading off to Harvard to pursue a PhD in theoretical and computational chemistry. And overall, VIPER really inspired me to think big, in big scale, not just small details. And I think that came from the fact that VIPER was a dual degree program, because it's across college and engineering, and that sort of gives you a dual perspective in terms of fundamental principles and also how to implement that to really solve problems, real life problems.
The students we saw today were quite incredible. They're doing important research, and it's being published. A number of these undergraduates are publishing in important journals, peer-reviewed journals, and I think that's extraordinary. And I'm delighted to see that many of them in this program are at Penn because of the VIPER program.